you can join me in appreciating this truly beautiful evening, a night that is absolutely ideal for a game of football. The scenes here really are something, a beautiful picture under the floodlights. Traffic and transport around here, not the kindest, but regardless of that, the fans have found a way of getting here. There is a sense of theatre and the decibel levels are rising. Nobody in this atmosphere can hide from the truth about how much this game matters. The scene overflows with colour and passion.
If you're just joining us, we are already underway.
So the signal to start the final round of fixtures in part one of two this season. Zielinski, and it's Rijkaard. Who do you, Jim, see making the difference here?
Yeah, Thibaut Courtois. He's a huge presence between the sticks, and that's not just because he's 6'6", Peter. He's got great reflexes, wonderful positioning, and he's a strong defensive leader. Think up...
Up for a header! Is nothing.
That is a really good chance missed, Peter, certainly the way he's been playing. It is still 0-0. And it's intense, this pressure from the front. No, he's not getting past him well. Gets away from his opponent. He's felt that, hasn't he? Well, that looks a foul. Yep, referee's given it. And the referee has shown him a yellow card. Protest continues, but in the end they are defending the indefensible. Well, I think the alternative was to stand there and do nothing while he tried to score. And obviously he's not going to allow that, Peter, is he?
Well, this may not be the kindest angle for a direct hit. Denied by a great piece of goalkeeping.
Well, I thought the starting position was good, and that helped the keeper to judge the flight of the ball and deal with it well.
Oh, good read. Robertson. Robertson going full tilt down the left. That's a decent ball. That's got behind for a goal kick. Himself into trouble there, free kick given away. And that has left him in a heap. Whistle's gone, that's a foul. Well, you might think he got off lightly. It is just a verbal warning. Just off target.
That's a little unfortunate. He had a lot of people worried then.
He's left his back.
in to... Well, players of his stature just live for moments like that. Another really important contribution as we near half-time, and it can make such an impact on each mindset.
That is a fine goal, really efficiently done.
Look, it's all about the timing of the jump.
After 45 minutes,
if you get it sniped, then you struggle.
Minutes has been indicated.
Well, I think the managers are going to have to scrap whatever they had in mind for the half-time team talks. One has got to tone it up now and the other has to tone it down.
That's good defending, very good defending.
And that will be the final action of the first half. So the end of the first half, both teams have had their moments. There's been no shortage of talking points.
Substitution on the field.
Been just one
number
goal.
10.
And that is the
number
state of it
18.
At the break. 1-0.
Coming on the field.
But you
number 20.
To give credit to the front and the half-time lead. I think the midfield
number
really
9.
Themselves on the back too.
Philippe
they work tirelessly for me.
Bayern Munich having to have the lead in a tight old game. Half-time, 1-0. The action has already resumed here.
Bayern Munich going well here, and they're in a good position.
Chance! Sticks it away!
And it's another really good show of character. I love the spirit and togetherness they muster. Never know when they're beaten. Just the sort of forward pass he's been looking for. Very telling.
And that has added a whole new complexion to the game.
Well, if anyone in this stadium thinks they haven't got value for what...
Good tenacity. Bayern Munich with their first corner, the first in the game for either side, actually. And that's been levered clear. Under's cross. Rijkaard finds himself offside.
Attendance for this match was 70,987.
Bayern Munich do have options available on the bench if they want to go that way. Casemiro played into space out wide.
Taking place.
So time for change, and this one has been on the cards for a little while.
Well, it's an interesting move this, Peter. It just gives opposition defence.
Karl-Heinz Rummenigge!
Bayern Munich take a two-goal lead and are looking good for the win.
Well, it's been an absolutely fabulous spell for them, and they're starting to look unstoppable. There could be more on the way.
Back on the ball again. It's gone loose.
They need to play this quicker in transitions like this.
Chappelle. Oh, he's bustling through here. And he's heaved it away. Interesting ball. Oh, that was never going to make it. He acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
Encouraged the pass with an intelligent run, but the
substitution
pass is
on the field. Number 22, Zielinski. Coming on the field is
looking for the runner.
Number 7,
Rummenigge.
Lo Celso.
Oh, great header!
That's just playing it safe and simple.
Well, he had a really good run at goal there, but the defence just weren't going to let him past. Oh, that's a key interception. Well, a glitch with the rangefinder there,
and evident annoyance.
Oh, that just required a bit more oomph to reach
its
target.
6 added minutes has been indicated.
Not too much more here than seeing our time, and time is very nearly seen out. A real chance if he can get through. Good running, strong and purposeful.
They've got to be quick moving this forward.
Last chance, perhaps. And time is up. Bayern Munich will be very happy with a job well done. An efficient win, for which the players simply did enough. Under voted man of the match, and deservedly so.
Well, after all of that, Jim, what are
we
you thinking?
Bayern Munich were victorious here, and rightly so. When you're allowed free license to strut your stuff in wide positions, we could only see one winner. And I just really liked what I saw here.
So thank you very much, Jim, for joining me. That brings us to the end of our coverage. So from us both, a very good evening.